Have you ever had a neck scan and been told you have a thyroid nodule? Suddenly, you're searching the internet, wondering if it's serious. Let's clear it all up. In this video, we'll walk through everything. Where the thyroid gland is, what nodules mean, and how doctors decide what's safe and what needs action. No jargon, just simple, clear facts. We simplify complex topics every week, so you never feel lost with your health reports. Let's begin. The thyroid gland sits just below the Adam's apple. It wraps around the front of your neck like a butterfly. Most of the time, you don't even know it's there until something changes. Though small, it produces hormones that control your body's energy use, metabolism, heart rate, temperature, even brain function, all regulated by thyroid hormones. Thyroid nodules are lumps or growths inside this gland. They might appear in one spot or across both sides. Some are deep, some are closer to the surface. Many are found by ultrasound, not touch. Most nodules are harmless. Only a small percentage turn out to be cancer. And even then, thyroid cancer tends to be slow-growing and treatable. Nodules can form for several reasons. Cell overgrowth, fluid-filled cysts, inflammation, or iodine deficiency. Often, the cause is unknown. Some nodules are solid. Others are filled with fluid. Some produce hormones on their own, called hot nodules. Most do nothing and require only observation. You might feel a smooth lump that moves when you swallow, but usually they're silent. Most nodules don't affect your hormone levels, but if a nodule becomes overactive, it can cause symptoms like weight loss, anxiety, or a racing heart. It's common to have more than one nodule. That's called a multinodular goiter. It doesn't automatically mean anything is wrong. What matters is how the nodules behave. Some nodules stay the same for years. Some grow slowly. Cystic ones may shrink. More than half of adults over age 60 have at least one thyroid nodule. Many never know. You're not alone. Over 90% of thyroid nodules are benign. Still, each one is checked carefully to rule out cancer. Ultrasound features like irregular borders, microcalcifications, or a taller-than-wide shape can raise concern. No single feature confirms cancer. It's the overall picture that matters. Many nodules are found by accident in people with no symptoms. That doesn't mean they're dangerous, but they still need proper follow-up. Most thyroid cancers are slow-growing, especially papillary cancer. Caught early, treatment is highly effective. A benign nodule rarely becomes cancer, but changes in size or shape may lead to re-evaluation. Nodules are more common in women. Hormones and autoimmune conditions may play a role. Risk also increases with age, especially under 20 or over 60. Radiation exposure in childhood from therapy or environmental sources also raises the risk. Benign nodules are usually followed with repeat ultrasounds every 6 to 24 months, depending on their appearance and growth rate. Red flag symptoms include rapid growth of voice changes, swallowing difficulty, or firm lymph nodes in the neck. Sometimes a doctor feels a thyroid lump during a routine exam, but most nodules are found on imaging, like CT or MR, eye scans done for other reasons. Ultrasound is the best way to evaluate thyroid nodules. It shows their size, structure, and any suspicious features. Blood tests like TSH check thyroid function, but they don't show whether a nodule is present. Many people with nodules have completely normal thyroid levels. If a scan picks up a nodule, your doctor may follow with an ultrasound. Sometimes, a radioactive iodine scan is used. to check whether the nodule is active or inactive. There's no guaranteed way to prevent nodules. Maintaining normal iodine levels helps, but nodules can form in anyone. During a thyroid exam, your doctor will feel the neck, check for symptoms, order lab tests and ultrasound, and decide if further testing is needed. The main test is a fine needle aspiration biopsy. A small needle takes cells from the nodule for lab analysis. It's quick and often done with local numbing. Most people say it feels like a pinch, not painful. Results usually come back in 3 to 7 days. If the result is benign, that's good. It means no signs of cancer. In that case, monitoring is all that's needed. If the result is unclear or suspicious, your doctor may repeat the biopsy, send the sample for molecular testing, or discuss surgery. Biopsy results are classified using the Bethesda system, a 6-level scale that helps guide decisions. Benign nodules don't usually need surgery unless they're growing, causing symptoms, or causing cosmetic concerns. Even if a biopsy misses cancer, ongoing monitoring with ultrasound helps detect changes. Follow-up usually means repeat scans every 6 to 12 months, and then less frequently if the nodule is stable. Most people with benign nodules don't need treatment. They live normal lives with occasional checkups. This is called active surveillance or watchful waiting. There are no medications that shrink nodules in most cases. Treatment is only needed if hormone levels are abnormal. Surgery is done when nodules are confirmed or suspected to be cancer, cause pressure or symptoms, or keep growing. The risks of thyroid surgery include bleeding, voice changes, and low calcium levels, though these are rare in expert hands. If the entire thyroid is removed, you'll need daily hormone pills for life. Most people tolerate this well. Larger nodules can cause hoarseness, trouble swallowing, or neck pressure. The long-term outlook for people with benign nodules is excellent. Lifestyle changes can support thyroid health, but they don't shrink nodules directly. Iodine-rich foods like fish, dairy, and iodized salt may help prevent deficiency. For trusted information, start with your endocrinologist or visit sites like the American Thyroid Association. Thanks for watching. If this helped you, tap like and subscribe to RRJ Health. We simplify your health reports, one topic at a time.